I have been watching your lectures on YouTube since last September. I first started listening because your style was cool, and I found your teaching to be such a treasure, so I listened sincerely. I live nearby in Pohang and decided to come see you in person since a Jungbub study group meets here. I was first introduced to them in March and came to the meeting in April. Something came up 5 minutes after I first met them, so I had to leave early, and as I was leaving, I got into a car accident. While making a U-turn, the other car crashed into my car from behind. Why did this accident happen? As soon as the accident happened, I thought, was I going somewhere unnecessarily? I immediately started placing blame. But then I remembered that Seuseungnim said that we shouldn't blame. So now I wonder, why did this accident happen?
There exists the law of accidents. Accidents are a process. They don't just happen today. There is a principle of suffering and pain. So if you are a patient, it is part of a process. If I have pain today, it's not because I did something wrong today. Everything that happens in the universe happens as part of a process. So don't think, why did this accident happen now? In order to know why an accident happens now, you should understand how accidents occur. A major accident never occurs initially. It is small at first. Small accidents. If you don't reflect on yourself and learn a lesson from the small accident and continue to live just like before, then you'll have a bigger one. You just take care of the accident and still don't learn from it, then you will suffer a bigger one. Accidents are a process. Why is it a process? Nature is letting you know something is approaching you now. This means difficulties are approaching. So be careful from now on and look back on your life. When you start to have mild pain, it means that illness has begun. So check how your life is going. Pain never comes if you live correctly. It only comes when you live wrongly. Accidents and illnesses operate alike. An accident is a process, so if you don't get hurt and the car is scratched, rather than cursing, you should think, oh, since this is happening to me, nature is telling me to be careful. You should control yourself and be more careful. But instead, you show your irritation. It was just a little scratch first, but the next accident will definitely crash the side of your car. A collision occurs. You get angry and just deal with it. Later on, someone else collides with your car. But you still don't look for the problem within you. Did I rush? Did I make a mistake in the past? You should have reflected on yourself, carefully looking at many things. But again, you just swear and blame others. So you get in a bigger accident. This time, the shock of the accident reaches your neck. You grab your neck and curse again. And you blame others. You still don't introspect. You keep trying to get better while doing physical therapy. When you get better, you just live your life as you please. Next, the accident will reach your lower back. Nature is saying, lay down in the hospital for a long time now. Hence, you can't walk around on your own. Why doesn't nature allow you to move around? It is restraining you. Hospitals and prisons restrain people. You are confined. You want to go out, but you can't go out on your own 2 feet, so you are restricted. Then why are you confined? To guide you to think deeply without moving around. You are confined and forced to reflect on yourself. Then, after your body has healed, you just go on your way. Next, you'll be constrained for a longer period of time. If this happens when you're in the hospital, then you'll be confined to a hospital bed. If this happens in jail, then if you don't realize your faults, you would be imprisoned for a longer period. This means that the person who went to the hospital is bound to go to the hospital again. If you ask yourself, why did I get hurt? And why do these things keep happening? Had you thought it through deeply, repenting for your mistakes, and trying really hard to put an effort to get it right, then you should live differently than before. You should live opposite to the way you were living before. If you set your mind like this and live that way, you won't go to the hospital anymore. You will stay far away from the hospital. This is why hardship comes to us, to make us learn something. It's the same reason why people don't have wealth and become poor. When things get hard, why do such unfortunate events keep happening? And why is nature taking strength away from me after giving me power? You should think about this and re-examine yourself. But you curse and blame others that you have suffered a loss. Then, nature will take your wealth a little more. After being ripped off by someone, you have resentment and you blame the scammer and tell those around you that the swindler is bad, and you act like you are innocent. So then nature takes away more. This is a process. This is also an accident. Being deceived is an accident. Being insulted by someone is also an accident. When something bad comes to you, it is a reminder for you to learn something from it. You must make an effort to stop the process. Don't go down any further. Do not have any more difficulties. After you manage yourself a little bit and study, you will be able to regain strength. Nature helps you to get back up. It's never right to blame others. People blame because they don't know the principle behind it. You lose strength each time you blame others. Furthermore, if you complain about others again, you lose more power. What does this mean? Nature never gives you a situation to blame others. But that's what people are doing. That's why people face difficulty, but they don't know why life gets hard. If people don't know this principle, there is no way to avoid hardship. It is a great mentor who teaches the principle of living correctly so that life doesn't become difficult. I am not a person who gives you good luck or a lump of gold when you don't put in your effort. Nature gives you everything that you need. I teach you how to enrich your life by properly managing your given situation. That's how you can live well with your own strength. Just because you are nice to me and wishing for something doesn't mean that I'm going to do anything for you. I am teaching and guiding you step by step to completely solve your struggles. You had a car accident and you thought, is it because I came here? No, that's not the reason. It was a process. So when you got there, it was just the right timing and the accident happened. You should think, oh, this is happening to remind me. Appreciate this reminder and consider, am I being a little careless these days? That's how you should think for yourself. Do you understand?